for the St. Louis Post-Dispatch. He's our good friend. He's also a award-winning author, Nick Pistor. Nick, welcome back to Big 550 KTRS.
Good to be here.
Has your book won any awards?
It hasn't won any awards yet, but if it would, it wouldn't win any until next year.
Oh, okay. Well, it won my award, so that's why it's an award-winning book. All right.
And the McGraw Seal of Approval.
That is exactly right. Let's get to Mayor Slay. He's got a wish list. What's he talking about here?
Essentially, if this quarter or three-quarters of a cent sales tax were to pass for transportation projects throughout the state of Missouri, each county, and I guess the city serves as a county, has to submit, you know, what they would do with that money. So for the city, it would be about $250 million over 10 years. And Mayor Slay yesterday announced a list of proposals that would sort of really dramatically shift the city's transportation policy away from what a lot of the other places in the state, particularly the rural areas, would be doing with their money, where the mayor wants to take the city in an entirely different direction by focusing on pedestrian-friendly things like sidewalks, like reducing lanes on roads, this streetcar initiative as a way of getting people around the city so you don't necessarily need to have a car. And you'll still be all right. And that's something that's very popular with younger progressive types who are moving into cities all across the country. But it's also something that has a net benefit for people who are poor or may not have the money to own a car. And those are the types of things that he's looking at.
All right. This is the just so we're all on the same page, Nick Pistor, joining us via Skype. And you can watch us at STLTODAY.com or at KTRS.com. Just so I understand this correctly, this is that same sales tax that our governor, Jay Nixon, was came out strongly against, right?
Correct.
Okay. So Mayor Slay, Democrat.
Wait, no. The governor has put it on the ballot for the August election.
Right, but he came out against it.
Yes.
Right.
But Charlie Dooley, the county executive, has also expressed, I guess, some concern about it.
Some reservations. But what's interesting is they're all Democrats, and Nixon's against it, and Mayor Slay is for it. I just wanted to make sure people knew what was going on there. All right, so in terms of his wish list, first let's start with some public transit, buses, roads, trains, light rails. What was on that in terms of that type of public transportation?
Yeah, essentially, St. Louis for a long time has been considering this streetcar initiative, which would link downtown to the Central West End. It's sort of a throwback to the streetcar system that we had, you know, 100 years ago or so. That's one thing that they would invest, I think, $35 million in to really get that off the ground. I think it's important that they've been trying to look at ways to get people down the what they call the Central Corridor, which, you know, runs from downtown to the Central West End, to really improve transportation there. They're also looking at changing the Metrolink station at the Skinker to Bolivar station near Forest Park, as well as doing some things at the Metrolink station at Laclede's Landing. Some other areas they're actually just looking at, like Tucker Boulevard, which is a wide road, looking at reducing some lanes there, making it a little easier to more people are living. People are wanting to be able to walk around. People are wanting to also bike, and that's what this proposal also includes quite a bit of linking these neighborhoods through bike paths. And it's quite expensive to do that. And so Mayor Slay's really throwing a lot of money in this proposal at that, as opposed to building more bridges or more roads or more pavement. The one thing that is included in his plan, though, is a new interchange at 20th Street, which would link, I think, a lot of North City to an interchange like that, particularly Paul McKee's project.
Right. What I find disappointing in this is everyone's talked about this streetcar, light rail, something from downtown, you know, through St. Louis University and onto the Central West End. That's all well and good, but what about a light rail system from like North County to downtown? Those are the people who really could benefit from a light rail system in terms of getting to and from work. Nick?
Oh, he is froze he frozen?
Up. Costs $1 billion for one Metrolink, like spur, I guess they would call it. If you ran one up to North County or South County or wherever, it's $1 billion, and they don't necessarily have that money, but that would also take a lot of regional cooperation from St. Louis County, from the Missouri Department of Transportation as well. And those are initiatives. Missouri Department of Transportation has not been overly willing to fund a lot of these projects for light rail.
Right. But they have money for a light rail system from downtown to the Central West End, but they don't have money for a light rail system from, say, Baden up in North City all the way downtown or something?
Well, when they built Metrolink, they essentially built in a contiguous line from the Metro East Scott Air Force Base out to the airport. So kind of anyone along there benefited, and that was an extremely expensive process. Now I think the key is to move it up and down throughout the city to get people from those areas access to that type of transportation, but there's simply no money. And like I said, light rail is not a priority for the Missouri Department of Transportation.
Yeah, interesting. This is his wish list. How much of this wish list has to go through the Board of Aldermen, and how much pushback is he getting from other people after this wish list was released?
Well, not too much. I think a lot of it is, people are still learning this process. This sales tax has really kind of just come out of nowhere, and it's going to be on the ballot in August, and the cities and the counties have had very little time to actually get this deadline to show people what they would use with this money. And so I think a lot of people are still letting it sink in and trying to figure out if that's what they want as well. So you're not hearing necessarily a loud, opposition or support for it at the moment. But it'll be interesting to see what happens, because the city, while they're considering, while everybody across the state will be considering this, the city's also considering putting on the ballot in November a property tax increase that would raise money for infrastructure as well, and that would be a $200 million bond issue. So you're going to see a lot of people being asked to raise their taxes. So I think it'll be interesting to see if any of these actually happen.
Yeah, that is really interesting. As of now, though, this 3/4 of a cent for transportation projects, you mentioned the city in your story in the paper, the city would get projected $270 million over 10 years. The tax doesn't go away after 10 years. It's an ongoing tax, correct?
I'm not exactly sure how this one would be structured, but I do think that those sales taxes drop off at some point.
Gotcha. Nick Pistor, great job as always. How's the book going?
Going well. It's in a second printing, and hopefully it'll go to a third.
The book is called, what is it? What's it called?
The Axe Murders of Saxtown, unsolved axe murder from 1874.
Anybody call you about movie rights or anything like that?
Not yet. My phone is open, though.
I think, you should, the NSA is listening to this phone call.
Well, that's true.
I still think that would make a great movie, so I wouldn't be shocked if somewhere down the line somebody calls you about movie rights. Nick, thanks for checking in. Always good to hear from you. Be safe, and we'll talk to you soon.
All right, talk to you soon. Bye.
You got Nick Pistor here on the Big 550 KTRS via Skype. And when I say that means you can watch right along with Nick Pistor as he calls in from his headquarters at his world headquarters at nickpistor.com.
I like that name.
Nick Pistor?
Nick Pistor.
Nick Pistor's the goods. Nick Pistor's got...
he's so talented.
He is, and he's like an old school reporter. He's got the tweed jacket on, the tie's a little undone. I want to see him with a little fedora that says press on the side.
He's not that old school.
He's kind of old school like that. 8:30, Big 550.